Today, I'm visiting the Tucson Master Gardener Demonstration Garden, run by the University of Arizona Cooperative Extension. Now, I've learned a lot in my short time visiting here, and today I want to share one of the simplest but coolest and cheapest gardening techniques that people just kind of forgot about for a long time. See, back when the conquistadors colonized the Americas, they brought with them this one secret trick to grow plants with only a tiny fraction of water that they usually needed. Of course, the indigenous people adopted it right away, particularly those that were living in really arid climates like the southwest of the United States. However, when more complicated systems like the drip system came into being, the olla technique just sort of faded into obscurity. But now, many universities and gardeners are turning to them again because they save so much water and they're so easy and cheap to set up. The essential concept of irrigating with olla is described in this publication by the University of Arizona Cooperative Extension. Basically, you have a porous pot and you have it filled with water. And as you can see in the demonstration gardens here, basically that water seeps into the surrounding environment like so. You can see it in this picture. The most important thing is that it's plugged on the bottom so that it doesn't leak out. While you can get special pots that are curved and designed to be ollas, you can actually very cheaply just turn a regular pot into it, and you can use the dish that you'd normally use as a catch dish for the top to cover it, again, as seen as in the demonstration gardens. And if you took those pots out of the ground, you would see that the roots have developed around the pot because the rest of the soil is dry. And so what you've effectively done is you made it so that the water mostly goes to the root system and doesn't go to the surrounding soil to evaporate. You minimized evaporation. Effectively, if you're able to minimize the amount of water that you can use, and then you can harvest rainwater like they do here, depending on how you set it up, you could get it so that not only aren't you using water from your water bill, but you might actually be generating water. You might wind up having to cut back on the water collection, depending, because this can be really effective for the plants that it's effective for, and it can be effective for many different plants, depending on the spacing. I would encourage you to do more research on your own. A great place to start is this publication by the University of Arizona Cooperative Extension, AZ1911, in the description below.